the audit profession to be more vigil. No longer we can say merely a watchdog and we are not going to bite. So these are the challenges before the accounting profession. We have to work towards for bringing out more glory for this profession by bringing more disclosures through our reporting system. The entire reporting system has to be modified with reference to the present context. Another very important challenge what we have to learn, information technology is completely taking over a profession. Nobody can say that I can go there and watch, see the voucher physically and going to conduct an audit. It's an impossible today to conduct a corporate audit without understanding what is information technology is taking place in the corporate. The corporate revolution through information technology is totally changing the face of the accounting profession. It's the biggest challenge to us to understand the computers, understand the software, understand its language, understand its reporting system is also very important. In India, we have started the XBRL system, Extensible Business Reporting Language, is an important tool for us to analyze the entire financial statement. Government has come out with mandatory requirement to complying with these things. What is an audit function relating to the assurance function, and there is a reporting function, all these things are very important for us. So these are the challenges thrown open before the accounting profession today. These are my view, that's been an opening. We can say that there will be a number of areas, maybe all of my colleagues may have a different views on that, different perspective they can bring before us. We can have a good debate. And once again, I thank the organizers for this wonderful opportunity.
Thank you very much. Mr. Vatwal.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I was really looking at the topic that we have been given, which really speaks on fostering talent for leadership. Now, this is a very important area because as far as professional bodies are concerned, how we are really going to foster this talent for the leadership role that we are placed in. Now, if you really look at the profession itself, the accounting profession, you have those who are involved in the, who have been trained to become the professional auditors, and then of course the others who are going to be the professional accountants in business or going into the business or service sectors. So there are two different sectors that could be really involved, and we one of the most important things is, are we really selecting the right type of people for the profession? Because I am really saying this because if a person goes to a university, you will always find that 99% of them would come with a university graduation. But if you become sit for a professional exam, it is entirely different. So whether the education has to be really suited or to be done in a manner that would really bring up the not only the education areas but also the training that is being given to suit them, so that when they sit for the examinations, they are able to get into this sort of role. So leadership is really important, because one of the most important things that has to be done is that once you really coming to the profession, very few may be able to get, make that grade. If you look at the number of CEOs who are in companies, then you will find that at one stage, the professional accountants have been able to get into this sort of field. But unfortunately, you might find that now the other professions are really coming into the field, maybe the engineering field, the marketing field, the human resource area. So you find that there is a lot of competition that is coming, and as a result of which, I think our younger professionals have to be trained in these sectors so that they would be proficient in order to meet the challenges ahead of them. So this is another sort of challenge that is there for the accounting profession, and I think we should really take this into account. Then the communication is another most important thing, because communication is something of great importance, because especially if you go, especially in the private sector, the multinational companies, they would really look at the communication, how well you could communicate and maybe act with the global partners, the local partners and others. And communication is also a very important role. So I feel that there are certain traits that should be embedded into the youth, so that they are being talented or they get really skilled in those spheres, and I am sure in the professional field, if we are really to come forward, then these traits would have to be taken into account by all the professional bodies. Thank you.
Thank you. Before Mr. Raman, we have just been informed that the president of the Institute of Chartered Accountants in Nepal, Mr. Pandey, is also here. So if we could invite him onto the stage, Mr. Pandey. We'll get you to talk at the end. Raman sir.
May I begin by invoking the grace of Almighty, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Good evening, friends. It's an excellent opportunity to be here as the president of the South Asian Federation of Accountants. And may I use the given opportunity at this moment to congratulate and compliment the glorious paths laid by the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Pakistan and that wonderful contribution to the state of economy, the Pakistan economy at the national level, as well as the contributions they have been making at the global level. Me personally, I had the opportunity of working with intellectual caliber personalities from ICAP in the boards and committees of the South Asian Federation of Accountants. Mr. Saqib himself is such a specimen, and we have his wonderful wisdom in the board and other proceedings of SAFA. We have in the past, I had the opportunity of working shoulder in shoulder with Mujahid Isahi Saab, Kalikur Rahman, and many others from ICAP in the committee and board of SAFA. I would always cherish those wonderful moments. And in particular, I have always been dumbstruck by the language of Mujahid Saab. Janab Mujahid is my role model for the type of flowery language and the flow which comes from him in articulating many of the points. With these few words, congratulating the ICAP on behalf of SAFA and on behalf of the Institute of Cost and Works Accountants of India, with the permission of the coordinator, I would like to proceed to make my observations. Now, as given the hints given to me by him over last night email, I would have broadly two parts. One, what has been done in India in the past, and second, how we are going to be moderated by the unfolding future in this particular region. Is that a right assumption I have? That is the way in which I would like to go about. And the overall setting for me, as Lakshman did, would be the focus of the professional accountants in business. We have got excellent colleagues and experts from the auditing field. They would be copiously giving you all the observations, but I would like to confine myself for the simple reason, not only I chair the Professional Accountants and Business Committee of SAFA, I also have the opportunity to be in the PAB Committee of IFAC, along with an illustrious nominee from ICAP, Sir Yaqub Suthar. So myself and Yaqub Suthar are able to make a very good contribution in the IFAC's PAB, and by and large, my observations will be focused on the domain of the professional accountants who are working in business or who are in employment. I would be coming from that particular angle. The first part in that angle is what has been in the past as far as India is concerned, what sort of contribution the professional accountants in business have made. I would rather make these views on behalf of the both accounting professions in my country and not confine myself only to my institute. I would draw upon the accounting education standards of 3 and 4 issued by IFAC, where one standard restricts itself to the basic content of a professional accounting education, consisting of the accounting knowledge and skills, the values we need to cherish as accountants, ethics and the attitude we need to build. This is supposed to be common for all the accountants who are coming out with the label of the professional accountant. But what is not taught in this and what you need to acquire as you develop in your career after getting the accountancy qualification is precisely what I am going to emphasize on. And these skills are largely intellectual in nature, technical and functional skills, largely dependent upon the personal skills one which exhibits, interpersonal and communication abilities of the professional, and